Hey guys, my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 17 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about the integration between Logistics Pipes and Applied Energistics to Storage, and in this episode we'll start talking about connecting two Logistics Pipes networks remotely or one network with two different locations. So let's get started. Alright. So, as you can see, I currently got myself two separate Logistics Pipes networks set up, each with their own logistics power junction. This is very important as each network needs their own power supply, keep that in mind. So, as you can see, this system has a couple of things, just a regular logistics request pipe and a chassis Mark 1 pipe, which is set to extract. And then on the other side, I got myself a chest that has the provider module and polymorphic item sync module, and just a logistics crafting table. As you can see, they are not directly connected, only by means of an ender chest and a logistics inventory system connector pipe. This is the actual pipe that allows two separate networks to talk to each other. How these logistics inventory system connectors works is surprisingly easy. Pretty much what they allow you to do is, once connected to the same inventory, so if both networks share the same inventory, and you right-click the logistics inventory system connector pipe with a wrench, as you can see there's a logistics item card in here, which you craft using the logistics soldering station. You have to actually use it or make it in the soldering station, because the frequency on this card is determined in the crafting, so if you cheat it in, it won't actually work, so keep that in mind. And then you just put one card in one of the inventory system connectors and the other card in the other one. So normally what you would use is a regular chest or something in the middle and just one pipe on one side and the other pipe on the other. Now, the most likely reason why you're here is because you want to see it work remotely. And of course, that works pretty awesome with ender chests. So make sure the inner chests are the same color, and again the logistics inventory system connector pipe has the same logistics item card in it. If it doesn't have any valid one, it should turn red in a minute. Yep, as you can see right there. But if I put it in, it will realize like, okay, this is a valid location, it's all good to go. So as I already said, on this side of this network, I have myself a chest with a couple of items in it, and a logistics crafting table, which has set the recipe for a crafting table. And then on this side, I got the requester pipe. What would it do, you might ask? Well, it's actually pretty cool, because if I were to request items, as you can see, I can access them from the other network. So let's say I want 10 oak planks. As you can see, they are requested from the chest, sent into the inner chest. Because these things are smart enough to talk to each other, this thing should know like, okay, I'm expecting these items, it's currently in the inner chest, and will be taken out and sent to the location. Pretty cool. And of course, this works both ways, so I set that to be the location where wood is allowed, and I got an extractor module in this one. It's taken out into the chest, and the rest is done on the other side. Pretty awesome. And of course, this works well with crafting too. So let's say I want to craft four crafting tables. As you can see, it's performed nicely on the remote side. It's sent into the ender chest and it's dropped over here. Pretty freaking awesome, don't you guys think? I didn't really know that this was an actual feature in logistics pipes up until recently. So I definitely want to use this in my future builds a lot more often. So awesome. With that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed and most importantly found it very educational. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comment section below. And of course, if you have any other suggestions for tutorials, feel free to let me know too. Be sure to like, comment and subscribe. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.